Hey guys, so today I'm just going to do a quick video on how to breed mealworms. So whether or not you're doing this for lizards, reptiles, hedgehogs, whatever, if you have a lot of lizards like me, it just makes sense to breed your own worms to feed them. So what I did was got this container from the dollar store, cost about $2. Overall I spent under $5 to make this, so it was great. So what you want to do is you want to make three different components for your worms. Now in the top container, what I did was use an X-Acto knife and cut out the bottom of the plastic drawer. And I just hot glued in a sheet of, like a screen almost, that has holes in it. And this is the container for my beetles. So I put this at the top because when the beetles, lay eggs, the eggs fall through the mesh and into the second drawer, which is the eggs and babies. Now, you can't see any in there now. Oh wait, yes you can. Oh cool. Wow, okay. This is the first time I'm actually seeing the worms in here. I don't know if you guys can see that. But the little guy's moving around in there. This is actually really exciting for me because I've been looking in this drawer for weeks and weeks and weeks and could not find any worms. They're just so tiny. Wow. Okay, that made my day. Alright. So like I said, the beetle's eggs will fall through the mesh, like it just did. The eggs will fall into here, they'll hatch into babies, and when they're big enough, you'll put them back in the bottom drawer, which is labeled mealworms. These are the full-size mealworms that I feed my geckos and bearded dragon. So what to put in the drawers. I use just normal, whatever, instant oatmeal. Just load up your drawers with those. They eat the oatmeal and they also burrow and lay their eggs in it, so it's perfect and it's really cheap to buy. So what you're going to want to do is get one of these, first of all. This is Zoomed brand. It's any sort of tongs, tweezers, whatever you want to call it, it'll do. So yeah, get these. Helps a lot, it's easier. So what you're going to want to do is, to feed your worms, get fruits, vegetables that won't mold really easily and won't dry up too easily. So I like to use orange peels, broccoli, and apple slices. Those three I find work really well. The rest I find get moldy and gross. So what I'm gonna do is take two of these. I tend to put more in this drawer because I feel like they use it more. Yeah. Take one of them, put it up in the beetles. Do that. Actually, wait, no. Take one of these out. Put it in the eggs and babies. They need food too. There you go. So now that you have food in all three drawers, you're all set. So, development of the mealworms, how that works. Basically, go to the pet store, buy one of these little containers of mealworms. It won't say larvae on it, it'll say mealworms. I usually go to start off this farm, I bought 250 packages. Cost me about, $5 for both of them. Started off with 100 mealworms, take them out of here, dump all of your mealworms from the pet store into this container. Now the life cycle of a mealworm, basically will go from, they'll go from these mealworms that you buy in the pet store, and from that stage they'll develop into larva. Oops. So larvae look like this. I'm squishing him. Larvae look like this. They turn kind of whitish. They'd stay in the larva stage for about a week or two, and then they'll turn into beetles. Oh look, he's already at the orange. They'll turn into beetles. So when they're in the larva stage, they actually don't eat, drink, or do anything. So smart thing to do, just take the container that the worms originally came in, label it larva. If I can open this. Oops. And then take your larva, pop it in there, put the lid on, and then just stick that on the top of your container here. Once you see they're in the beetle stage, then you take them out of the little container and stick them in here. And the cycle just keeps going. Yeah, and also something to note, the mealworms down here do shed their skin. I'll try and show you. So you might want to go through it, take out like every week, you know, take out the old food, whatever that's dried up. And this is all skin. So go in every week or every couple days or whatever and just clean out all of that, because it'll get gross if you don't. So that's about it. I suggest maybe right when you make this, keep this whole container in like a bin or something to make sure that no worms are getting out before you put it like in your room or whatever, so that worms don't go all over your room, because that would be really gross. And you're good to go. I feed these guys to, whoa, I tripped. I'm clumsy. I feed those guys to my leopard geckos. These guys love them, as well as my bearded dragon, who loves the mealworms. My crested geckos don't eat them as much. I try to give them a few, but they just aren't that into it. So, yeah. So that's that. If you have any questions or anything, just leave them in the comments or send me a message and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Alright, hope you enjoyed the video. Good luck. Bye.